हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ICS महेश पीयू कॉलेज धारवाड। लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिसीज। द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज अबाउट रोल ऑफ टी सेल्स इन सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी। इन केस ऑफ सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी टी सेल्स प्लेस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल बिकॉज whatever the T cells, they are produced from primary lymphoid organ, that is nothing but a bone marrow. And later on, they are considered as stem cells, and that process is known as hematopoiesis. Hematopoiesis is the process how these stem cells are produced. And later on, these T cells, they will get mature in thymus, because as we all know that these thymus is a site or an organ where T lymphocytes will get matured. Later on, these T lymphocytes, after getting maturity, they will move to secondary lymphoid organs, that is nothing but a spleen, Peyer's patches, and in this part, so these T lymphocytes, they will travel to this spleen and Peyer's patches or whatever may be the secondary lymphoid organs to come in contact or to deal with the pathogen. These T lymphocytes, how they will react or how it is going to deal with the antigen, we'll discuss in detail further. Sensitized T lymphocytes, when they will get contact with the antigen, they are going to form the clone of T cells. Clone means as it is copy of the T cells, and no doubt they are similar in structure, but they perform different functions. Okay, so that they have to increase their number. So in that part, we come across the four types of the lymphocytes, that is produced by the T lymphocytes after getting sensitized by the antigen. The first one is T helper T cell, killer T cell, suppressor T cell, and memory T cell. I will repeat once again, just T lymphocytes are going to deal with the antigen. So antigen, they will come in contact with the T lymphocytes in the secondary lymphoid organs like Peyer's patches on the spleen. Imagine now the antigen is available for the T lymphocyte. So now the part is, after getting activation or sensitization from the T lymphocytes, how it is going to react? So it is going to produce the clone of T cells, means the exact copy of the T cells, but they are of similar structure, but they are going to perform different functions. The four types of lymphocytes they are going to produce: the first one is helper T cell, second one is killer T cell, third one is suppressor T cell, and the fourth one is memory T cell. Now let us see each one of the cell in detail, how they are going to deal with the antigen. In case of helper T cell, as it has got the receptors, that is CD4 receptors, and these receptors will be get activated or sensitized by the antigen interaction, and they are known as lymphokinins. And this proliferation of other T cells, they are going to activate the lymphokinins, and the stimulation of B lymphocytes in turn, they will take place. As a result, such type of mechanism is going to attract the macrophages. Macrophages are also another type of immune cells we come across in tissues. And these macrophages, they are going to deal with the antigen so that it is going to be get lysed. Okay, and the second one is killer T cell. Killer T cell is directly, it's going to attack and destroy. How? When the microbes, they tries to enter into the system, they are going to identify the infected body cells, these killer T cells, they are going to identify whether it's a cancer cells or whatever may be the type, but they are going to directly deal with these pathogen or the bacteria or the virus or the cancer cells. Okay, so such type of activity we come across with a killer T cell, as that is the reason it has got the name killer, means it is directly going to deal with the antigen. Okay, and this killer T cell, when it is going to come in contact with the infected body cell, it's going to bind with that. Okay, and how it is going to kill? It is going to kill by secreting perforins. Perforins are the chemical content secreted by the killer cells as a result of the infected body cell or infected cell with the pathogen. As a result, it's going to produce the holes on the surface of this bacteria or the cell, that is infected cell. So it is also going to release the cell killing substance, that is called the cytotoxic T cell. And the third one is the suppressor T cell. Suppressor T cell, that is going to suppress the immune system, that is to prevent the attack of own body cells in turn. Because generally what happens, if the hyperactivation of the immune system is also going to damage our body, that should not happen. Okay, so at that time the memory cells, that is based upon the previously sensitized and the retained information in these memory cells, they are going to deal with the pathogen. Whereas the in case of T lymphocytes, whether it is a helper T cell, killer T cell, suppressor T cell or memory T cell. Okay, this is about the cell mediated immunity, means how the immunity is provided by the wide varieties of the cells of the T lymphocytes. So you can see here, in case of bone marrow, it's going to produce the stem cell in turn. As a result, it's going to produce thymus. As a result, it's going to make the T cell that undergoes the proliferation on encountering antigen. So it is going to produce the killer T cell, or by taking the help of helper cells, or by activating the suppressor T cells. But in case of memory cells, the four types of cells as we have studied in the earlier slide, these four cells, they will be get activated by the activation of the T lymphocytes. Okay, so they are going to, like the T killer cells, it is going to bind with the antigen and to destroy it, whereas the B cell, it's going to take care of the antigen anyhow by neutralizing that antigen. So the next part is about vaccines or vaccination. Okay, so in case of allergy and autoimmunity, I think we have heard that word allergy and autoimmunity. Allergy, when any person come in contact with the components of the nature, but he start feeling like uncomfortness or allergic reactions to the various components, like the pollen grains or wide varieties of components we come across. I'll tell here, I'll discuss on this part. Pollen grains, some are allergic to the pollen, some are allergic to the insect stings, and some are allergic to the molds, and some are allergic to the food mushroom, and some are allergic to the dusts. Any component or the substance that causes allergy, okay, is known as allergen. But one thing is very clear in this part, why some of the individuals are allergic and why can't some other persons, they don't have the allergic symptoms, it is totally, there is no proper explanation or the biological background reasons is not there. It all depends upon how your system is reacting to the situation. Okay, what exactly this allergic reaction? Allergic reaction is nothing but a exaggerated immune system or the exaggerated immune response. When our own immune systems will get hypersensitive, means hyperactivate, So at the time we start getting this allergic reactions. So like in case of allergic reactions, what happens when allergens they enter into our system? As a result, antibody E is produced from our immune system, and the mast cells, they are going to produce the components that binds with the, or the antibodies that binds with the allergen. Okay, in case of when allergen binds with the IEE antibody, it is going to produce the two chemical component. How, what type of chemical component it is? That is histamines and serotonins. So histamines and serotonins are the chemical component secreted by the mast cell as a allergic reactions produced in our body. Okay, as a result, these histamines and serotonins, they enter into our bloodstream, into that intercellular space. So you can see here how the histamines, they will travel. They travel to the intercellular space, that is from blood plasma, leaks out from blood, and which increases the permeability of the blood vessels. And as a result, you'll start getting the exaggerated response to the immune system, like continuous sneezing. Okay, and this continuous sneezing, like symptoms like continuous sneezing, watery eyes, running nose. So these are the symptoms we come across. In some of the cases, what happens? You start getting the small rashes on your skin. Okay, that is also a symptom of, that is also a type of allergic reactions. So in case of allergic reaction, so why you will get such type of allergic reaction? That is mainly because of misconceptions, or the like confusion of our immune system. Like what it will do actually, antibodies that is going to secreted as a result of allergen, it is not so much effective antigen it is going to come across. Do you think a pollen grain is going to cause any disease or what? No, it is not possible. But confused, our immune system, when it will get confused, what it will start thinking, okay, this antigen is going to harm our system. As a result, it is also going to produce IgE antibody. As a result, in case of mast cells, they are going to produce histamines and serotonin. So we start getting the symptoms. Okay. And in case of next part, that is autoimmunity. That is the type of immune response in which the mistakenly targets the normal body cells and the tissues. You can see the Graves' disease, the symptom of the Graves' disease, or rheumatoid arthritis. This is generally observed in case of aged person. For this autoimmunity also, there is no proper explanation why our own system is going to kill our own cells. If you start harming your own family members, means it is also a type of autoimmunity response. So what you are going to get it from that? So such type of reaction that takes place in case of human body is known as autoimmunity. So allergic autoimmunity, in the next session we will discuss about AIDS. Okay, thank you students.